Hey guys, welcome back to another video with me, SilentCiel here. So we are going to continue off with where we left off. Okay, that did not come out right. So we're gonna continue where we left off on World of Final Fantasy. So we just gave the golem the item that it required for it to clear the path. So yeah, let's keep moving. And hopefully, so there's a chest here. So we got 3 potions, cool. Alright, so... Oh, that's cool. Story still continues. I wonder if I can actually stack her on my head. That'd be cool. Let's take a look, see whether we can do that. Okay, so we can't stack her on my head. That would be cool if I could. Oh yeah. Dashing in without listening. Oh man, things are not going to turn out right. And it's a behemoth. Merc Rifts. Scary but true. Merc Rifts are home to strange, rare, and usually very dangerous mirages. If you want to explore one, make sure that you're fully prepared before diving in. So I guess it's part of the tutorial. So yeah, so part 2 will be also part of the tutorial, so this is turning out to be quite a long tutorial. Yeah, but I heard the game mechanics for World of Final Fantasy is rather unique, so I guess it's a necessary time spending, you know, to get yourself customized with the gameplay. Alright, so oh, it looks so cute. Alright, so speeding things up. What in the world is unstacked? Okay, so... So we do have a new skill thanks to the... Oh, okay. So, the SML basically means the stack positions of your characters. Oh, that's really cool. So S means small, medium, large. Okay, so each character has their own skills. Ram is basically what we taught our little chocobo to do, if you remember in the last video. So we're gonna try ramming. That did not do a lot of damage. Oh my goodness, that's so screwed. Okay, so I guess let's just continue attacking. We definitely what? Have to defend, I guess, for this battle. Oh my goodness. He literally just KO'd us. Are we supposed to faint in this mission? Let's defend and see what happens. So by defending, we actually get to choose, I mean we get to move much earlier, unlike the attacking, so we're gonna defend again just to see how much the... Oh okay, so we didn't really take a hit this time now. I'm gonna attack. Do you think we're gonna die? Yes, we do die. So what happens if we completely wipe out? I guess it's part of the tutorial. Yeah. The story goes on.
あ、でも今は二人の命を守ることだけに限定されてるので、さっきみたいに戦闘で負けた時だけのことなのです。あとあと、タマのその命はここでしばらく休めば元に戻るので、亡くなる前にここに戻ってきて休憩を希望するのです。
了解了解、全然 OK、 たっぷり休んでくれ。
はい、なのです。何にしてもありがとね、タマ。人の話聞かないで突っ込んだのが原因だけど。
Alright, so apparently we just learned the mechanics of dying or losing a battle. So yeah, Tama loses a life, which is kind of sad. It reminds me a bit of like the ReZero anime where Subaru keeps dying and resetting his timeline just to move forward by doing the correct scenarios. So it's kind of sad that they've implemented such a story plot into this game. I mean, even though Tama seems proud because Len praised it for, you know, having such a skill, but you know, if your comrade loses a life every time you die, and if it's permanently removed from them, their lifespan, it's kind of demoralizing. Especially if it's a close friend. So yeah. So when the party has fallen, when the entire party is defeated, Tama will whisk everyone back to safety of Ninewood Hills. There is no penalty, but you will have to fight your way back to where you were. Oh my goodness, okay. So be careful though, if you're inside the threshold of a powerful mirage, Tama won't be able to save you, it's game over. So only certain mirages then will be able to be saved? Okay, so good to know. Was that Selfie? Alright, so I'm gonna have my sister walk around as her usual size as well. Wonder what this is. Is it a save point? Ah, sorry, it is a save point. Okay, so we're gonna save. Alright, data, yes. There we go. Okay, moving on. So in this area, apparently we don't have a map because it's only the gateway. Oh, it's so cute. I guess the star is where we're supposed to go. I'm just gonna take a look around just in case. Don't wanna miss out anything. It is a Japanese RPG after all, so there might be some like hidden secrets or whatsoever. I guess there's nothing here. I hope we're going in the right direction. Oh, there we go. Okay, it's not selfie. She's wearing a chocobo outfit. What in the world is she? That's why in the world.
So,
and there we go, we have the chocobo song. And although it's a bit mixed up, you know, for each different series of Final Fantasy, there will be a different type of chocobo song. So I never really expected a character like this in Final Fantasy games, but I guess World of Final Fantasy is kind of like a cutesy spin-off of the series, so yeah. But still, I didn't really expect a character like this. Okay, so she's a shark. Oh, it's so adorable though. But it could have gone maybe less lewd with the costume. But oh well. So Chocolaté has a habit of picking up all sorts of strange items. Those items can be yours if you're ready to fork over enough of Grimoire's currency, which is known as gil. So if you guys aren't familiar with Final Fantasy by now, currency in Final Fantasy games are known as gil. The part where she picks up items and sells it to you, I mean, picking up items is a thing for Chocobo games, especially if you play Chocobo Dungeon, and if I'm not wrong, the PC version of Final Fantasy VIII and even the PlayStation 1 version, there was a device that lets you run Chocobo, the Chocobo mascot that helped you pick up items for the game itself. So the Chocobo will definitely pick up some awesome items like that's Pokemon. Like items that fully heal your character, you know, the kind of things that are very rare that you find in games. So Final Fantasy VIII was the first that implemented such a thing. And then after that, Chocobo Dungeon also had it, and so yeah, I guess we finally brought it back into World of Final Fantasy, which is pretty cool. Alright, Chocolaté Mark's selection is always improving, blah blah blah. Okay, so we're gonna take a look at what she sells. So we've got the standard potions and all that, so let's see. Pick me up, why in the world is it pick me up? Sleep, okay. So I guess we're too poor to buy anything right now, so we're just gonna browse. Oh my goodness. She reminds me of one of those very colorful characters that you can see in Akihabara. So they purposely put on a persona like that just for the portraying of their I would say anime character.
かわいい風の妖精 セラフィーちゃんです。
The personality and the face really do not match, but that's how anime characters are. That face though, kind of remind me of the PlayStation 1 game Pararapa the Rapper. Yeah, so if you guys never heard of it, please go Google it up. It's an awesome music game for the PlayStation 1 that was super annoying. Annoyingly difficult because, oh my goodness, look at the amount of text and that voice acting. That voice actress is awesome. Alright, so I guess she's not gonna be on my sister's head. I thought she would be. Oh well. Anyways, so she apparently is a Mirage safe bank. So yeah. Yeah, okay, so I can select her from the save options. Seraphone is a special device you can use to call Seraphie. It says your prism case remotely. she's a very lazy character. Right in the world. Oh well. This game has really, tickled me in all my expectations for this series. Characters are full of life, full of fun. I gotta say, this is definitely one of the better games that I bought this year. Yeah, very enjoyable. So if you guys love the game, I mean if you love Final Fantasy, I definitely recommend you picking up this game title. So yeah, I enjoy having fun. So I guess what's this? We have befriended a new Mirage. Okay, so we're definitely getting her for the sister, I guess. But this hair is a different color. It's so adorable. Okay, where? She just appeared out of nowhere. Okay, so we're just gonna... Oh, I just realized that we could have jumped. We could jump. Okay, so we're gonna slot her in. Oh, wait. So, we can't? Or is it because of the size? Ah, it's the size. No wonder. Okay, so we're gonna have her equipped. Yes, there we go. So yeah, pressing circle lets you jump, but the jump is like really short. Oh well. So let's see. Prism case.
Garden gem no koukan desu ka?
Somehow I find voice acting, characters with this kind of voices where they are like half beat or half interested in you, kind of attractive, I guess. I mean, it's not that I like to lower my standards of being noticed, but I mean, what's the proper English term here? Demean myself, I guess. But somehow or other, it has a kind of attractive beat to it, you know, like, I'm not an M, you know, or maybe I am, I don't know, well, that's for you guys to judge, but, oh well, Okay, so let's go take a look at all the stuff here. So I guess we just have to select whatever we want to store in. So I guess we have nothing to store at this point of time. We could just talk to her. Okay, that wasn't really useful. Never mind. Okay, let's go here. Let's head back to the room, see whether there's anything new. So, yeah, apparently the sister sleeps on the bed. It's so cute, the chocobo. The footsteps, the sound of the footsteps too. So adorable. Okay, wait, let's rest. HP AP restored. Fantastic. Let's see if we have anything to increase for the Mirage boards. Let's see. So, first one will be Whisper Wind, inflict magical wind damage, and restore an equal amount of HP. Wow, that's not too bad. It has like two effects at the same time. That's pretty useful. Alright, let's see. What does Tama have? I have 1 SP, won't be doing much with that. And little Chocobo has nothing as well. So, here's something interesting. If you guys didn't know, my nickname, Ciel, actually came from a Final Fantasy character. So, it's not from Final Fantasy IV, if you're wondering. Okay, so like I was saying, my name didn't come from the Dark Knight CL. Came actually from the animated series Final Fantasy Unlimited. If you guys have not heard of it, go Google it up. If you guys can find the series, go watch it. It's fantastic. It's a very different style of Final Fantasy storytelling, and the characters are awesome. You know, so my name came from a chocobo. Rather, my nickname came from a chocobo. Seriously? I'm really wondering what kind of story this game will have. The story is starting to like get very confusing as Kingdom Hearts. I mean, at the beginning part, who in the world are we? I don't know, like we lost our memories and all that, so we had to go through all this training again to figure out what the hell we are doing. Then we meet this lady, and she says she's a god, but I don't think she is. She's probably like some keeper of time or something like that, you know. Well, let's play on and see what happens, you know. Because, oh boy, yeah, the story is gonna be one heck of a confusing thing. Alright, speeding up conversation. Are you the impatient type? Here's a fun little trick. When cutscenes, you can hold R to quickly speed through the conversations, or not good enough for you, then you can always press start, then press triangle to skip. So it feels like a visual novel. If you guys do know your Japanese pop culture, especially with the otaku side, you know what visual novels are. So they finally implemented something like this for a Final Fantasy game, which is quite interesting. Normally, Final Fantasy stories, you don't have the fast-forward skipping story. I mean, you can skip the entire scene, but not like have it sped up through to complete. Yeah, so so that's pretty interesting to have. It's the first for its kind. So yes, I'm gonna save. Yes, as you can see, it's always one save file. So that's kind of sad for Final Fantasy series, especially if you want to get back to a particular scene. So now we finally are introduced to the save crystals, even though I used it earlier. So, like some of the save points in other Final Fantasy series, these like these ones, they do heal your HP and AP, which is similar to FF10. I'm not so sure whether FF9 had it like this, but I don't recall it actually healing anyone. So I guess FF10 was pretty much the first one where the save points actually fully heal your party, I guess. Correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, well, I'm still learning. Alright, so let's go in. Where are we going? No, we're not gonna access the prism case. That'll be meaningless since we are still new. So I guess we only have one dungeon to go to. So let's head there. Oh, you can change leaders? So changing leaders is just for fun. So, okay.
There you go.
So I'm gonna change. Alright. I thought the battle sequence would be like those that you just meet on the map itself. So I didn't expect it like the standard Final Fantasy WoW encounter type. Yeah, that's cool that they still have it. Speeding up battles, tired of the grind, hold R during the battle fast forward. So we found out about this function by ourselves. You can also enable auto battle mode with a single press of select. In this mode, the party continues. Oh, that's cool. So that will save a lot of time. So let's just go with the auto battle mode. The targeting with the basic menu. When you're using the basic menu, enemies are targeted automatically for you. However, you can always override this when used. So yeah, we found out about this as well on our own. So we press select. So it's gonna have the auto battle icon here. That was pretty easy. So I guess it's like FF10, because if your character doesn't act, your character doesn't gain experience. So EXP you earn in a battle is split between all participating party members. Mirages that are accompanying you but didn't fight in the battle still receive a flat 8% of the total EXP earned. However, Mirages in your prism case get nothing. So make sure to bring... Okay, so yeah. Good to know, good to know. Let's move on. Okay, I have two tiny chocobos. Alright, so bear with me guys, the battles at the beginning are usually very dull, especially if I plan to grind, but I think I'll probably grind on my own time so that I won't bore you guys out. I'll just mostly focus on the story portion of the game. Yeah, so I don't think we can handle Behemoth at this point in time.
So
Well, that's pretty useful. I just wish they had the auto fight battle button on the touchscreen itself. So, you know, I'm using the older model of the PlayStation Vita, so the select and start buttons are pretty tiny and quite hard to press, especially when I have such pudgy fingers. I mean, I have large fingers. I'm a large person, so yeah, it would help if they had the button function on the touchscreen itself. That would definitely make things a lot easier. So we finally get the opening video to the title. So yeah, this probably concludes the tutorial. The song, I hope I don't get copyrighted for it. Oh my goodness. If I do, I have to replay it again. Oh boy. So yeah, hopefully won't get flagged for this portion of the game. Oh, there's an animated version? Oh, that's really cool. So, I wonder if they're gonna make an anime series for this game. That would be very cool. At this point in time, I'm just really wondering when the download for Sora will be available, especially if it's going to be available for the Asia or even the US version of the game. So hopefully it's not exclusive to the Japanese version of the game. That would be kind of sad. You can see all the many different characters, even the equipment from different Final Fantasy series. I recognize most of them, but to be honest, I didn't finish quite a few of the Final Fantasy series, especially FF1 to 3. I finished 4. I loved 4, especially because of its very new style of playing out of the old generation of Final Fantasy series. So FF7 wasn't really unique in terms of the gameplay, but the story was fantastic, as you can see from the multiple sequels from FF7. FF8 and 9 were groundbreaking gameplay differences, so yeah.
予言に歌われる兄弟。
Alright, so we're back here. We're into chapter 2. So I wonder how many chapters there are. It feels like an open world, but it seems like a linear path as well. Yeah, I guess it's a linear path, just that there's no map to show us that it's a linear path. So there's a train. A cactar train. That's cute. Even a cabin looks like a cactar. So there is a giant car. I wonder if there's like a Lilikin car. Okay, so we have chibi characters walking around as well. Ah, so adorable. So it's like the black mage and the white mage. Oh my god, it's like, is this the first time we have a character speaking? I don't remember any Final Fantasy series where a character actually talks. It's so cute. When in the world do we get tickets? Indeed, why is it semi-lifetime? Does that spell out bad news for our adventures? Oh my goodness. Is that a honey pot? So I guess there are towns where your characters cannot be in their giant form. That's pretty cool. I mean, cute. Well, I mean, Cornelia? Okay, that sounds familiar. Anyway, like, most of the Final Fantasy games from the first generation, from 1 to 4, the characters were in the pixelated tiny form, so yeah, I guess this is where World of Final Fantasy took the Lilikin form from.
ミラージュで作られた軍隊です。ミラージュを使って軍を作ってるの？
まあ何でもいいや。とに
手だってなら手に入れないとな。
ちょっとさん、
Right. So our first battle in the first new town is stirring up trouble immediately after we got here. That's not nice, I guess.
Habanero君だかなんだか知らねえけど、覚悟しろ。
なんだかスパイシーなのです
。So if we speed up, we can't actually hear what they talk. So yeah, let's try not to do that again. Let's see, Whisper Wind, let's do heal. I don't think we need to heal now, so let's just attack. So as you can see, we can select the enemies. It's gonna attack. What just happened? What? Wait, when did I catch it? No. So I guess that's part of the story because I didn't click imprison. So yeah, so I think they're trying to show that we can't imprison a mirage that already belongs to someone else, I guess. So it's pretty similar to Pokemon.
あのミラージュを包んでいた光は他の支配者がいる証なのです。
支配者？
違います。簡単に言うと、あのミラージュは他人のものなので、
持ち主を先にギャモンと言わせないと
なかなか捕まえられないのです。
So I guess we should turn tiny for this town. Oh look, it's Kekka. The cool thing about this game is if you're at the area where you're supposed to go and they are still talking about the story, you will pause there and you won't be able to move. So you have to wait until they finish talking before you proceed on. That's pretty cool.
あらためまして、コーネリアを治めておりますセーラと申します。
お姫様ってこと？
そうだったんですか。すみません、特にラーンがいろいろと群れを働きまして。
俺だけ？
私は姉のレーンと言います。失礼しました。
いえ、こちらこそ。最初はバハムート軍のものかと疑ってしまいまして。それなのに、先ほどはバハムート軍のミラージュより町をお守りくださりありがとうございました。
あ、いや、そんな丁寧にされると困る。
何 何急に慌ててるの。でも確かに私たちそんな大層なもんじゃありませんので。
そうそう、少々くらいなもんなんで。
はい、少々なんて言葉初めて聞いたのです。
すみません、とても予言に歌われている方々には見えませんね。
予言？あ、そういえばさっき町の人たちもなんかそんなことを言ってたような。
失礼しました。少し順を追ってお話しさせていただきます。ここコーネリアはグリモワルの中層にある非連邦国です。
非連邦国？
はい、現在グリモワルでは世界中のほとんどの国家、自治区がブレンディレス密会王を頂点としたバハムート連邦王国に参加しています。しかしコーネリアは未だ連邦には加盟しておりません。連邦からは幾度となく加盟するように達しがあったのですが、断り続けるうちに侵略まがいの行為をしてくるようになって。
それがさっきのミラージュたち？
はい、
さっきおっしゃっていた予言というのは？
青の予言の分岐に関するくだりです。再び刻まれし時、丘よりの大人、異界より来たる訪問者として帰らんかの者たち、世界に二つの分岐を生み出す。それはクゼとなるか破滅となるか、大いなる意志の届かぬ闇の中。
破滅とクゼの分岐。
クゼ？
クゼ！お前マジでクゼ！
弟たちは無視してください。分かっているのか、いつヒルのことを言ってるんだとしたら、友達関係ないとも言えないのか。あの、少々ぶしつけな質問かもしれませんが、
グリモワルにいるミラージュは支配の大小こそありますが、ほぼ全てが連邦の管理下に入っています。連邦の後ろ盾さえあれば、国民は普段の生活におけるミラージュの脅威から解放されるのです。
世界中のミラージュを管理？マジで？
はい、マジです。
Princess is like trying to learn slang.
でも協力するにしても、もう少しミラージュがいた方がいいんじゃない？ 私たちミラージュがいないとまともに戦えないし。
そうだな。お姫様、ここらにいろんなミラージュがいる場所ってあったりするのかな。
それならここから北東に進んだところにネブラの洞窟という野生のミラージュが数多く生息している場所があります。
あるんだ。
でもそこはかなり凶悪なミラージュの報告もあるとても危険な場所です。もし行かれるようでしたらくれぐれも注意なさってください。
ありがとうございます。肝に銘じさせておきます。
させてって俺のこと？俺だけ？
Oh my goodness, both of them are so funny. Rather, the entire game and their characters are also witty. Alright, so gonna save the game process here. And we'll end the video to this point. So I'll see you guys in the next part, probably in another few days, cause I'm gonna switch over from here to the Macross Delta series. Don't want to leave out the Macross fans as well. So until then, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.